Tesla design in combination with Loki special equipment is the necessary condition to start servicing Tesla. The use of Loki enables us to diagnose Tesla vehicles, perform maintenance operations, and extend the existing functionality of electric cars. All we need to start working is to connect the device to both an MCU and a Wi-Fi access point. Here we have the MCU from Tesla Model 3. To connect it, we need a Loki module and an appropriate cable. The cable should be connected to the module terminal. We connect one end of the cable to the MCU and the other one to the battery charging port of the car. In our case, we have a standard mobile charging unit. Lighting LEDs BL and MS signal a complete boot of the module, which takes about 20 seconds after the device has been connected to a power supply. Upon the boot completion, the Wi-Fi access point is activated and we connect to it via the computer. Then we launch the appropriate program and select the vehicle. In our case, it is Tesla Model 3. We follow the instructions displayed on the screen and run the program. The program shows the vehicle status connected. Then the same program displays the activated modes of the vehicle. Now the monitor is off and the MCU screen is inactive. We can switch it on with this button. The vehicle is awake now and the MCU is active. We check the current status of the vehicle using indication data and the buttons. For example, to start the diagnostic procedure, we must switch the vehicle to either developer mode or factory mode. Now we can check the parameters, read alert codes, and view diagnostic information. We press this button to enter developer mode. As soon as the diagnostic menu and the title Developer Mode appear on the screen, we are provided access to more detailed information about the faults of the vehicle systems. Also, we can view other data displayed in this window. In addition to it, this mode can be used to switch to factory mode by pressing the button. If it fails, this mode can be activated through Reset All Data in the latest firmware files. Factory mode, when enabled, allows us to enter developer mode regardless of the vehicle rebooting. The only difference is that developer mode is active only before rebooting, while factory mode stays enabled until we switch it off. On the one hand, in most auction cars, Valet mode remains enabled, and on the other hand, they still have protection set by the former owner. Valet mode can be disabled through the account menu as with it being enabled. The vehicle can neither be connected to wireless networks, nor can its trunk or glove box be opened. For Valet mode deactivation, it is necessary to know a 4-digit PIN code set by the former owner. That is why we added the function of PIN code peak reading to the Loki menu. Firstly, it allows us to deactivate Valet mode. Secondly, we can read the PIN code set by another owner. In addition to Valet mode, modes pin to drive and speed limit can be also deactivated. Apart from these functions, we can use the LAN port to read the vehicle information or activate rail, so the vehicle could move without a keycard in case of its loss or absence. For example, we can activate rail and we also can change the gears in drive, which allows us to drive the vehicle without a keycard. In addition to controlling the vehicle through the LAN port, we can read all the current alert codes on the vehicle. More comprehensive diagnostics and, as a matter of fact, decoding of all errors are performed based on the alert codes. Most of the auction vehicles are provided with American navigation, which is not able to plan roads throughout Europe. Therefore, the functions of navigation installation, firmware upgrade, and patches installation were added to the device. Navigation can be installed in quite a simple way. We select the file, make sure we download it as a map file, and press Next. After it, the ECU joins the process of upgrading and navigation installation begins. As we can see, navigation is being installed now. Also, it is necessary to change the map region installed in this MCU. To have it done, we switch Loki on, select Model 3 Gateway, activate the program and select the European region on the top page. This way, we install navigation and ensure its correct operation. It follows from the above that Loki is a user-friendly and multifunction device essential to those who are engaged in diagnostics and repair of Tesla vehicles.